Hello children, I am Prasanna. In this video, I am going to explain 5.4 exercise of unit 5 triangle and its properties of 7th class. In my last video, I have explained the same exercise 1 to 5 sums. Now we will continue with the 6th sum children. Find the values of x and y in the following figure. Here they gave a triangle and here these two sides are equal. If the triangle is having two sides equal, we call it as an isosceles triangle. A triangle in which two sides equal, we call it as isosceles triangle. Okay? And you know the isosceles triangle property, children. The equal sides, wherever the two equal sides are there, the joining of this vertex opposite sides angles are equal. Okay, so that is angles in an isosceles triangle. Here these two sides are equal. Here is the common point of these two. Opposite side of here is this one. So it is having x and y. I can say x is equal to y or y equal to x in any way. These two angles will be equal. Okay, children. So here we can say x equal to y. X degrees equal to y because angles in an isosceles triangle. Okay, so here x equal to y. Now I can take angle sum property now. Here if you take angle sum property, 70 degrees plus x degrees plus y degrees is equal to 180 degrees. You know angle sum property, sum of the three angles in a triangle is equal to 180 degrees. Okay, now here 70 plus x degrees plus, in place of y I will write x. Or you can write in place of x, y. Anyway you can do. Equal to 180 degrees. So 70 degrees plus x is 2x equal to 180. Coming to next step is transposing 2x is equal to 180 minus 70. Take this plus 70 to the other side. It will become minus 70. So 2x is equal to 180 minus 70 gives you 110 degrees. So what is x here? 110 by 2. So x degrees is nothing but when you cancel, you will get 55 degrees. Therefore, the value of x degrees is 55 and the y is also 55 because x degrees is equal to y degrees. Coming to second one, here is a triangle given. X is given exterior angle and y and 50 are interior angles. We should find x and y value. So exterior angle is equal to sum of the two interior opposite angles we can take, but we don't know what is y. If you see, it is an isosceles triangle, children. Here the opposite angles of equal sides are equal in an isosceles triangle. See, these two sides are equal. The common vertex of these two sides is this point. Opposite of this is this side. Means the opposite angles of equal sides are equal. So angles in an isosceles triangle. So I can take angle y as 50 degrees because you can write opposite angles of equal sides, or you can write angles in an isosceles triangle. So you got the value of y now. Now here this is 50. Now exterior angle property we can take, children. Exterior angle is equal to sum of the two interior angle, opposite angles, right? So here x degrees is nothing but y plus 50. That is exterior angle property. So x degrees is nothing but y, we got 50 plus 50. That is x degrees is nothing but 100 degrees. So finally we got the value of x as 100 and y as 50. Coming to third one, this is the third one, children. Find the value of x and y. Here if you see this, these two are vertically opposite angles, yes? So we can take y as 30 degrees. X is given here. Here y you will get 30. What about this? Here there is no angle given, so you can take any other alphabet, children. Here I am taking z. Okay, so here we use first angle y equal to 30 degrees. They are vertically opposite angles, right? Now here y you got as 30. Now if you see these two sides are equal, means isosceles triangle. If these sides are equal, opposite to this angles are equal. That is angle y equal to angle z. Equal angles of an isosceles triangle. So therefore, angle y degrees is nothing but z degrees. That is equal angles of an isosceles triangle. That is, z is nothing but 30 degrees because we got y as 30. Now z value 30 you got. Now consider this triangle, children. I can use angle sum property there. That is, x degrees plus y degrees plus z degrees is nothing but 180. This is nothing but angle sum property. So what is x? We don't know. What is y? 30 degrees. Z is also 30 degrees, is equal to 180. X degrees plus 30 plus 30 60 equal to 180 degrees. X degrees is equal to 180 minus 60. That is x equal to 120 degrees. So finally we got y as 30 degrees and x as 120 degrees. Next question. Fourth one, here is the triangle, children. X and y are the angles, interior angles, and 110 is the exterior angle. I can use your exterior angle property, children. That is 110 is equal to x plus y, but we don't know the value of x and value of y. If two values are unknown, we can't find, right? So first we need to find this angle. You'll take this as z. Can I take z and 110 as a linear pair? Z degrees plus 110 degrees is equal to 180. You know linear pair. Sum of the two adjacent angles on a straight line is 180 degrees. Okay. Then what is z here? 180 minus 110 degrees. That is z is nothing but 70. So finally you got the z value as 70. Okay, children. Now if you see, these two are equal sides of an isosceles triangle. Two sides are equal, we call it as an isosceles triangle. So these two angles will be equal angles in an isosceles triangle, equal angles. Okay. So I can take angle y degrees is equal to z degrees. This is nothing but equal angles in an isosceles triangle. So what will get the value of y as? Therefore, y degrees is nothing but z we got 70, no? Yes. Since z is equal to 70. Now you got the value of y as 70. Now we need to find the x value. One method we can take exterior angle property, that is 110 is equal to x plus y, or we can use the angle sum property in a triangle. Okay, so in any way, you can do. X degrees plus y degrees plus z degrees is equal to 180. Here I am taking angle sum property. So what is x? We don't know. What is y? 70. Z also 70 is equal to 180. X degrees plus 70 plus 70, 140 is equal to 180. X degrees is equal to 180 degrees minus 140. That is x value is 40. So finally we got x as 40, y as 70 and z as 70. Next, fifth one. Here is the right angle triangle they given, children. Here this is called 90 degrees. Okay. Now we should find the value of x and y. So I can take here exterior angle property, that is y equal to x plus 90, but we don't know y and x. So first I will take y and 30 as a linear pair. You know, linear pair, sum of the two adjacent angles on a straight line is 180. So y plus 30 equal to 180. That is y is nothing but 180 minus 30. That is nothing but y is equal to 150 degrees. So you got the y value as 150. Now can I take exterior angle property, children? That is, angle y is nothing but x degrees plus 90 degrees. This is exterior angle property. Exterior angle equal to sum of the two interior opposite angles. Y you got as 150 is equal to x degrees plus 90, and you can write x degrees plus 90 is equal to 180, 150. X degrees is equal to 150 minus 90. Equal to how much? 150 minus 90? 60 degrees. So the value of x equal to 60 degrees and the value of y equal to 150 degrees. Now last sum in this bit, children. Here x is the interior angle, y is an exterior angle, and 80 is also an exterior angle. We need to find the value of x and y. So here I will write A and here B. Okay. First we will take vertically opposite angles, children. A equal to 80 degrees, that is vertically opposite angles. So A you got 80 degrees. Can I take angle sum property here? No, because I don't know the value of x and value of b, right? And if you use, this is an isosceles triangle, equal angles in an isosceles triangles, if you take, you will get these two angles as equal. That is, x degrees is equal to b. Equal angles in an isosceles triangle, right? Now, we'll keep like this only. Now, here we take angle sum property, that is A plus X plus B equal to 180, angle sum property. So, in place of A, I will write 80 degrees, in place of X, I will write X, in place of B also, I will write X, because we are having X degrees is nothing but B. Okay, children. Now, here X plus 80 plus x is nothing but 2x is equal to 180. 2x is equal to 180 minus 80. 2x is equal to 100. X is equal to 100 by 2. So when you do cancellation, you will get x as 50. So here you got 50. Okay, children. Now, you should find the y value. If you see, this is 50 means b is also 50. Why? Because x equal to b. Either you can take a linear pair of this y and 50, or you can take the exterior angle property, that is y equal to a plus x degrees also. In any way you can do, children. Here angle y is equal to a plus x degrees. Exterior angle property. Or you can take linear pair also, b and b plus y equal to 180. So y degrees is nothing but a we got as 80 and x we got as 50. So y degrees is 80 plus 50, 130. So finally we got the x value as 50 degrees and y value as 130 degrees. Yes, seventh word problem, children. One of the exterior angles of a triangle is 125 degrees and the interior opposite angles are in the ratio 2:3. Find the angles of a triangle. We'll draw a figure here. So this is a triangle. Suppose this is an exterior angle. It is given as 125 degrees. And coming to interior opposite angles, they are given in the ratio. So we can take one angle as 2x and one other angle as 3x. Because they are given in the ratio. We need to take as a part. So 2x and the 3x. Okay, children. So what is given here, ratio of interior opposite angles? Equal to 2:3. And the exterior angle is given how much? 125 degrees. Can I use exterior angle property here? That is 2x plus 3x equal to 125 degrees. This is nothing but exterior angle property. That is, exterior angle is equal to sum of the two interior opposite angles. So 2x plus 3x is how much? 5x equal to 125, and x is equal to 125 by 5. So when you do cancellation, 25 you will get. So x degrees is equal to 25. But we need to find these two angles. In that first angle is what? 2x. That is 2 into what is x value here? 25. That is nothing but 50 degrees. Okay, children? And coming to second angle. Second angle is nothing but 3x. That is 3 into 25. So you will get 75. So when you add 50 and 75, you will get 125 degrees. So finally, you got that exterior angle is equal to sum of the two interior opposite angles. Next, 8th question, children. The exterior angle PRS of triangle PQR is 105 degrees. If angle Q is 70, find angle P. And still question is asking, is angle PRS is greater than angle P? So first we'll draw figure, children, here. Triangle PQR. And here exterior angle is given. That is, we'll take this as S. So PRS. PRS means this is exterior angle. It is given as 105 degrees. And angle Q is given as 70 degrees. And what is find angle P? So take, let angle P as X. So here I can use exterior angle property, children. That is, exterior angle is equal to sum of the two interior opposite angles. So X degrees plus 70 degrees is equal to 105 degrees. This is exterior angle property. So X degrees is equal to 105 minus 70. So X value you will get as 105 minus 70 will gives you 35 degrees. That is, angle P is nothing but 35. Okay. Now after finding P, they are asking whether angle PRS is greater than angle P. Here you know angle PRS is given as how much? 105. So which is greater, 35 or 105? Yes, 105 is greater. Therefore, angle PRS is greater than angle P. That is, 105 degrees is greater than 35 degrees. Next to 9th question, children. If an exterior angle of a triangle is 130 degrees and one of the interior opposite angle is 60, find the other interior opposite angles. Here we'll draw one triangle. Okay. So one angle, exterior angle, is given as 130 degrees and one of the interior opposite angle is given as 60. We need to find the other one. So we'll take, let other interior opposite angle equal to X. So we can use exterior angle property, children. That is, X degrees plus 60 degrees is equal to 130. This is exterior angle property. That is nothing but exterior angle equal to sum of the two interior opposite angles. So here X is nothing but 130 minus 60. That is, X is nothing but 130 minus 60, 70. Therefore, other interior opposite angle is nothing but 70 degrees. Coming to 10th question. One of the exterior angle of a triangle is 105 degrees and the interior opposite angles are in the ratio 2:5. Find the angles of the triangle. So here we'll draw figure. So this is the triangle and this is exterior angle is given as 105 and the interior opposite angles are in the ratio 2:5. That is, this is 2x and this is 5x. We should take the part ratio. We should not write the just number. Parts, we should, here one of the interior opposite angle is 2x and the other is 5x. Now I can use the exterior angle of property, children. Before that, what is the ratio given? You should write. Okay. Ratio of interior opposite angles is given the ratio 2:5 and exterior angle is given how much? 105 degrees. Now can I use exterior angle property? That is 2x plus 5x equal to 105 degrees. Exterior angle property. Exterior angle equal to sum of the two interior opposite angles. So 2x plus 5x is how much? 7x is equal to 105 degrees. X is nothing but 105 by 7. When you cancel with 7, you will get 7 ones are 3, 15 are. So x equal to 15. Okay. Now we need to find the angles here. Here first angle. That is 2x. Nothing but 2 into 15 gives you 30 degrees. Coming to second angle. 5x. 5 into 15 gives you 75 degrees. Okay children, when you add this 2, you will get 105 degrees. That is, exterior angle is equal to sum of the two interior opposite angles. Here, next one, last sum in this chapter children. In the figure, find the value of x and y. If you see here, this x is the exterior angle of this small triangle, isn't it? That is, x is nothing but y plus 55, but we don't know what is the value of y. If I consider the triangle ABC, y is the exterior angle. So if you take exterior angle sum property, y is nothing but 30 plus 50, isn't it? So first we'll take the big triangle, that is in triangle ABC, angle y is equal to 30 degrees plus 50 degrees. This is nothing but exterior angle property. That is, y is nothing but 30 plus 50, 80 degrees. So we got the value of y as 80. So here you got 80. Now children, what is the value of x? Now consider this small triangle. X is the exterior angle and exterior angle is equal to sum of the two interior opposite angles. Here already we got the value of y as 80. So I can take here x degrees is equal to y plus 55. This is also exterior angle property. That is, x degrees is equal to y, we already got as 80. 80 plus 55 degrees. So 80 plus 55 gives you 135 degrees. So finally we got the x value as 135 degrees and y value as 80 degrees. So by this sum, we completed this 50 unit triangle and its properties.